Well, guys, it's your guy Christine. We are back again, and on today's tutorial we want to build up a unit rate. We want to estimate a cost of an item. So let's briefly look at the components of a unit rate. We have the materials, we have labor, we have plant and equipment, and then we have profits and overheads. So guys, if you are new to this channel, kindly subscribe. Subscribe, share, and don't forget to leave a comment. Now, let's proceed to our build-up unit rate. We are going to build a unit rate for tile laying. So we are going to look at the cost of each component. That is the cost of the tiles, the cost of the screed, and then the cost of labor. That is the labor that we are going to require to lay those tiles. Now, we are going to... Now, let's estimate the cost of the tiles. Tiles laying. So we are building a unit rate for 152 by 152 by 16 millimeters thick tiled paving on 12 millimeters cement sand screed of ratio 1:3 per square meter. The data that we are given, the cost of 50 kg cement is 1440 kgs per meter cubic at 800. Cost of sand per ton is 1600 kgs per meter cubic at 1000. Bulking of sand is 20%. Shrinkage of mortar is 30%. Cost of tile per piece is 45. Higher rate of 300 liter mixer is 4000 per day. It has a cycle time of 5 minutes. Mortar joint is 6 millimeters. Skilled labor is 150 and unskilled labor is 75. millimeters, and then we are going to assume any other necessary information that we have not been given. So without further ado, guys, let's proceed. Proceed with me kindly, and don't forget to subscribe if you are new to this channel. And for us who are watching and we have not subscribed, kindly show some love and press that subscription button. Now let's get to the solution. We are going to start with the materials, and then we are going to assume our floor size of 1 meter length and 1 meter width. This floor size where we are casting our tiles, so that we can determine the number of tiles that we are going to need for that area. Now our floor area will be 1 meter by 1 meter, that is 1 square meter. The size of the tiles without mortar, we have been told, is 152 by 152 by 16 millimeters. Now that is the size of our tile, this tile here, and then we add 6 millimeters mortar to the length and the width. Now this length, we add 6 millimeters mortar, meaning we are adding 3 millimeters on this side and 3 millimeters on this side, and also on the width we are adding 3 millimeters on this side and 3 millimeters on the downside. Now new tile size is 158 by 158 by 16 millimeters. So area of the tile with mortar will be 158 by 158 millimeters. That gives us 24,964 square millimeters. So convert that into meter square, that is 0.024964 square meter. Now let's get the number of tiles that are in one meter square. So it's the area of the floor, that is 1 by 1, and then we divide by the area of the tiles with mortar, that is 0.024964. That gives us 40.06 tiles. And then we allow for 5% wastage, that is 1/5 of 100 times the tiles, that is 40.06. That gives us 42.06, say 43 tiles. Now we are going to use 43 tiles in an area of 1 by 1, that is 1 meter long and 1 meter wide. So this is an assumption that we have made for the floor size. So when you are doing the actual construction, just take your floor area. If it is 15 meters by 20 meters, get the floor area, and then from there you can be able to get the number of tiles that you need. Now the cost of the tiles will be 43, that is the number of tiles, times the cost of one tile was 45, that gives us 1935. So that is what we need for the tiles. Now we proceed to our screed. Our screed, of course, it is per meter square, because that is where we are going to lay our tiles. The screed ratio we have been told is 1:3, so the total ratio is 4 meter cubic. Let's start by getting the cost of cement, that is 1 meter cubic by the density 1440. It is a 50 kg, so we divide by 50 and then we multiply by the cost of one of one bag or 150 kg bag, that gives us 23,040. So you indicate your amount here. The cost of sand will be 3 meter cubic multiplied by 1600 kgs per meter cubic. We divide by 1000 and then we multiply the cost, that is 1000 per ton, that gives us 4800. We allow for 20% bulking. 20% bulking, that is 120 over 100 times the cost, that is 4800, that gives us 5760. Now total cement plus sand will be 23,040 plus 5760, that gives us 28,800. We allow for 30% shrinkage and waste, that will give us 37,440. Now this is the cost of 4 meter cubic. Remember our ratio, total ratio is 4 meter cubic. So let's find the cost of 1 meter cubic. So that will be 37,440 divided by 4 meter cubic, that gives us 9,360. So this is cost per meter cubic. Remember we are building our unit rate per square meter. So let's find the cost per square meter. So we'll take the cost per meter cubic, we multiply by the thickness of the screed, that was 12 millimeters. So if you convert 12 millimeters to meters, that is 0.012. so the cost is 9,360, we multiply by 0.12, that gives us 112.30. so that is the cost that we need for our screed that will cast 1 meter square. Now let's go to the mixer. Higher rate of the mixer is 4,000 per day. It has a cycle time of 5 minutes. We are going to assume 8 hours working a day. Output capacity, the mixer we are told is 300 liters, that is the capacity, so that is 0.3 meter cubic. Efficiency, we are going to assume 90% because the mixer of course cannot be able to produce the actual 0.3 meter cubic. So we give it an efficiency of 90, so the actual capacity will be 0.027 meter cubic. Now let's find the number of cycles in 1 hour of 60 minutes. So one cycle we've been told is 5 minutes, or about 60 minutes in an hour, that gives us 12 cycles. In one cycle we are able to produce 0.027 meter cubic. So how about 12 cycles? That will be 12, then the actual capacity, which is 0.027, that gives us 0.324 meter cubic. Now, cost per hour of the mixer, we assumed 8 hours working a day and the mixer was being hired at 4,000. So the cost of the mixer per hour will be 4,000 divided by 8, that gives us 500 shillings per hour. Therefore, that means in 1 hour, we are able to produce a mix of 0.324 meter cubic at a cost of 500. How about 1 meter cubic? So it will be 500 divided by the capacity that we are able to produce in an hour, that is 0.324, that gives us 1543.21. That is now the cost per meter square of the mixer. Now let's find the cost per meter cubic. Now let's find the cost per meter square. It will be 1542.21 times the thickness of the mix, that is the screed that we are going to produce, which was 12 millimeters, that is 0.012, that gives us 18 shillings and 52 cents. Now that we have the tiles, we have our screed, and we have been able to produce the screed. Now let's proceed to the labor and know how the quantity of labor that you are going to need for the work. So we are going to assume one operator, one skilled, two unskilled, working for 1 hour. The skilled labor is 150, so we have assumed two of them, that gives us 300. The unskilled is 75 per hour, we have assumed two of them, that gives us 150. That is giving us a total of 450 shillings per hour. So total material plus labor, we have 1935 for the tiles. We have 112.32 for the screed, and then we have 18.25 for the mixer, and then we have 450 for the labor. So that gives us a total of 2,515.82, and then we allow for 40% profits and overheads. That gives us 3,522.18. Therefore, the cost of laying tile per meter square is 3,522.18. So this is the cost that you need to lay tiles in a floor. Remember, a floor of 1 by 1, that is 1 meter square. Thank you guys for your time, and until next time, bye bye.